And we're back. Somewhere in the forest, not gonna tell y'all where it is. Try not to slip on these leaves, which is exactly what I'm about to do. In 3, 2, oh, okay, it happened before. Super stealth, but you can't expect me to have cat-like reflexes because cats don't like water. Okay, quota fulfilled, one lame joke. We got it. Let's go. Okay guys, I have to hit y'all a disclaimer. Don't try this. Kevin and I are both certified free divers and safety divers. We know the current, we're familiar with the spot, and most importantly, we know each other as dive buddies. Yes, he just so happens to be the love of my life, but when it comes to choosing a dive buddy, the relationship goes a little bit deeper. Ollie, catch that one, right? Okay, all right, cool. So we had to switch up the plan because the water wasn't calm enough for us to kind of climb down and slip right in. I would have had my fins in my hand and I'd put them on in the water, but instead we had to do this.
Hello? I'm putting on the fins? Okay, fins first. Let's tell her as bedroom slipper. This is what I mean when I say as bedroom slipper. The fins? Yeah, I'm gonna hold it. Okay. Okay.
Ollie, seeing all that cord? Let me tell you, that cord gonna make a comeback in this video, and I'm gonna be just as annoyed. But anyway, doing a last minute check, make sure I'm not tangled. I'm kind of sliding my boomsy down a little bit. Kevin just threw my buoy, and I'm in. Now, I definitely would have wanted y'all to see the drop, but it was way more important to hold on to the mask and the GoPro to prevent any loss, damage, or injury. I would have taken a little drop here to check the viz. I was happy, and then I turned around to tell Kevin. But there's that cord again. Y'all have no idea how irritating this is and how dangerous it could be if not handled correctly. I even forgot to turn around and tell Kevin if everything was okay.
What? Everything good? Easy, nice, feels good.
So while I was fighting up with the cord, which is gonna happen a lot, this is my least favorite type of cord to use, but it was my fault because I forgot my line in the crate. In the background, you can see in the shallows there that there was decent enough viz, at least for me. But as you guys know by now, I love that white water. I like hunting in those kinds of conditions.
It's not so bad, it really not so bad, it's nice. And it's on the current, I just chilling. Wait till to see a turtle.
So here I would have been making my first drop just to kind of scout the scene, see what's up, see how the viz is at the bottom. Because one of the best things that could happen when you drop in poor clarity is to find a layer of clean water right at the seafloor. But that ain't happening. So white water hunting it is. So at some point Kevin would have seen carried and I got really excited, and so this is how I was hunted for them because the water was so murky top to bottom. I just decided, okay, let me just make some slow ascents and see if I see anything. And it was slim pickings, Ollie. Like, I was very discouraged because I could barely see past my gun tip. I'm telling y'all, the GoPro definitely picks up a lot more than we see, because that 4K footage definitely picking up more than my 180 eyes. Around here we were trying to get some footage of a green turtle that Kevin had spotted. So I was asking him,
see on top of the water or on the bottom? Oh, okay, okay. I'll check. I'll do something too.
So I was making one last drop in this zone, hoping to see the turtle feeding. That would have been excellent. But mainly what we took away from here was the fishlessness. So by now we had moved to the rock we originally planned to check, so we weren't sightseeing along the journey anymore. We just got where we wanted to go, and I personally find the visuals a lot better. And then I saw my first shootable fish. So what did I do? Miss. Let's look at that again, shall we? My lad, that was the rookiest of rookie moves. My hand didn't even outstretch before I pulled the trigger, which is a sure sign of excitement and a lack of experience. Shame, shame. But every single dive is a learning lesson, and this is exactly why I love to do these videos, because if that was a different fish, like a really prized fish, I would be going home still telling Kevin, I don't know how I miss, but I definitely know how I miss now. Now, for those of you who are still wondering how I missed, you should note that gun safety and gun technique are kind of similar throughout the gun world, regardless of what gun you have in your hand. So, have y'all ever seen a movie where the guy is holding the gun like this? Wait, what? No, like this. Oh, yeah, I see that all the time. Oh, okay, so what is it supposed to look like? Like this. Oh, okay, cool. So the arm is outstretched, and if that lady wasn't just posing, she would have been watching straight down the barrel or the shaft of the gun, which would have essentially given her that accurate aim. So while all that teaching was going on, I was still fighting up with the core that I told y'all will come back to haunt me, and I will continue to do so. What song should we listen to?
Step out, get some air now. Let your edge out. Touch some ice, but you'll be heavy in my mind. Can you get the heck out? I need rest now. Got me bummed out. You're so.
Jip to fight, I'll stand too close. You off my mind, drown. Off this way, doing all these shows. I've been on the road, I don't care where I go, as long as I get paid. Bad little vibe, she been on my mind. Soon as I get back, she can slay. Do this all the time, this ain't no surprise. Every other night, another movie getting paid. Jip to fight, I'll stand too close. You off my mind, drown. Off this way, doing all these shows. I've been on the road, I don't care where I go, as long as I get paid. Bad little vibe. Every other night, another dollar getting made. Every other night started with a good day. I feel like a child, I got wrinkles in the face. I'm a dozen in the dollar, this shit is a parade. I don't want your train, I'm going to not a slave. I had no car, not too many, but you get tame. Tears ain't working, so I took a private plane. He puts a nigga like a
mama. Yes. That was a very big song for such a simple shot on a relatively decent fish. That was a monster song. And I really hope to get footage of me hitting a monster fish. And I'll use the same song over. I have no shame. But yeah. So originally when I was supposed to bring the fish, I fell for my knife and I didn't feel it. So I decided to put it on the stringer first to secure the fish. And here you'll see I'm gonna dispatch. And I think I was thinking to myself, maybe I should check again. And I was still trying to dispatch, and I decided to open the flopper and check. And I got my knife, and so I was able to brain the fish. Again, this is to ensure that the fish dies in the most humane way possible. Ensuring to secure the knife again, because that is how they get lost very often. And then you'll see that I'm very careful not to drop my spear when I'm dispatching. That's another way you could lose your gun. You'll see I have a float at the end of my gun as well. Not gonna tell y'all why. And then I set up to reload. Take it from me, it's really important to know your fish species and fish behavior. Kevin was fully aware that you don't see one pag, so he went straight to searching for another. I wasn't able to get any footage, but look at that beautiful stone shot. It's like a shish kebab. He got a really nice pag, and right then, the GoPro died.
Cheering on my mind, soon as I get back, she can shred. Do this all the time, this ain't no surprise. Every other night, another movie getting ready.